Dusty Tomes Audiobooks and Spoken Realms present A Generation of American Historiography by William A. Dunning, narrated by Joseph Tabler. The American Historical Association was born in 1884. This was a generation ago, as men roughly reckon the stages in the life of the race. It has been suggested that this meeting might feel some interest in the consideration of what has been achieved in this generation in American historiography. The suggestion is attractive and plausible. When, however, one starts to act in accordance with it, there arise the usual troubles about the definition and limits of the field. Historiography is a dignified and mouth-filling word, but what precisely does it mean? And in particular, what does it mean for him who has to deal with 30-odd years of it in one-third of an hour? From its etymology, the term is almost ridiculously simple. History means history, and graph means writing. Ergo, historiography means either the writing of history, or the writing about history, or the writing about the writing of history, which does not solve our problem at all. If the first sense is taken, though it is by no means the most logical or the universally accepted sense, we are confronted with the question, what is the difference, if any, between a historian and a historiographer? And is there any distinction, in form or in substance, between historiography and plain history? Must we dismiss as unworthy our instinctive conviction that the longer word connotes the greater dignity? That a man may become a historian by a single duodecimo volume, but may never get a footing in the sacred precincts of historiography on less than 5 volumes octavo, with a special library edition in calf with gilt top and uncut edges? Then we have us the perennial questions, is a textbook historiography? Is a textbook so successful as to develop into a shelf full of volumes through successive reincarnations adapted respectively to universities, colleges, high schools, 8th grades, 7th grades, and so on down to the sub-kindergartens? And is a great collection of sources historiography? Even if the collector be a man of the utmost industry and detective genius, and the results of his labor of the utmost significance to our understanding of a people or an age? And is a doctoral dissertation historiography? Even if it is 800 large pages in bulk and covers as many as 10 years in time? The answers to these questions, and others that spring at once to the lips of every reflecting person, I shall not undertake to suggest. If a presumption as to the answers is derivable from what follows, the paper will not have been written in vain. In a way, the present appears a peculiar favorable moment for reviewing the progress of historiography. For all our preoccupation just now is with what may be called, in contrast, historiography. From every recruiting center in the land has issued the injunction, endlessly reiterated on the billboards, don't read history, make it. We who have written books may feel certain momentary reserves about the first branch of this injunction, but we yield to none in earnestness of God's speeds to the myriads of our young men who have responded to the second. When they shall have made the history that the desperate condition of the civilized world requires, they will be the first to urge, approve, and promote the activity of those whose function it is to record and interpret their deeds. Looking back to the year in which the association was organized, what do we see going on in the writing of history? In 1884, the small group of American writers who had given distinction to historiography by works not concerned immediately with the United States had passed out of life or of influence. Irving and Prescott were long dead. Motley's Barneveld, his last work, had appeared in 1873, and the author died 4 years later. Parkman, a younger man, came back from general literature to history in this very year, 1884, with the volume on Montcalm and Wolfe that confirmed his position in the first rank of the historiographical phalanx.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.